Hi there guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Tian Conradi, I'm the Flying Dutchman, and today we're going to talk Nike Zoom Fly Tempo Next Percent. The Tempo Next Percent comes on the back of Nike's Alpha Fly, the sub 2 hour shoe that Kipchoge used. They've kind of like moved that technology into kind of creating more of a daily trainer for the Alpha Fly that's not as race specific as the Alpha Fly. So what Nike's done is they've basically replaced this shoe, the Pegasus Turbo, with this shoe. Both shoes have Zoom React foam and the Zoom X foam in the midsole. But other than that, it's really two very different shoes. They don't feel the same. That's kind of the only comparison that they share. So this shoe came up, very highly anticipated release. Nike, they changed the release date a few times to make it absolutely perfect. So here it is, and let's dig a little bit deeper and see what's inside. Let's start with the upper. Standard Flyknit upper. Nike uses that in quite a few of their shoes, and sometimes it's a hit, sometimes it's a miss. I didn't like the Flyknit upper in either the Epic React or the Zoom Fly, but I found in the Tempo Next that the upper is a little bit more snug. You'll be able to see there's a little bit of a wraparound on the inside of the shoe that basically wraps the arch a little bit. It's got a very soft, narrow heel counter, so the fit from heel to midfoot is nice and tight, so it actually holds your foot. You don't have that moving around inside the Flyknit upper, and the forefoot is nice and spacious. So I really enjoy the fit, especially for me that's got quite a wide foot. I think the upper works well. You can see that it's got a little bit of a double overlay around the toe bumper, just to provide a little bit of stability on to the upper, just to give it a bit more structure. And I like that because that's something that the other Flyknit uppers never really had. When we talk going to the midsole, right? So we're looking at a React Foam Zoom X midsole combination, the same as we had in the Pegasus Turbo, and the two combined quite nicely. I do feel that with the added volume in the stack height here with the Tempo Next Percent, that the shoe performs a little bit harder than the Pegasus Turbo. It's not as soft and forgiving, so it's a little bit more robust in that regard. It's got a little bit of a plate, a nylon plate that sits right on top between the two midsoles. That provides it with a little bit of forward propulsion. I do find that you roll over the forefoot in this shoe a little bit better than we did in the Pegasus Turbo. Your foot works a little bit harder in the Pegasus Turbo, where here the shoe does a little bit more work. And then of course in the midsole we have these little pods at the bottom here, the AirPods, that provides that responsive spring and pop as you go over the forefoot. I did find that you feel these parts on the foot quite a bit, so you might need a bit of time to really get into the shoe. But also you find with the ZoomX foam and in the front here, is the minute you transition over the AirPod, the shoe really just suddenly falls over, and it really provides a nice rollover onto your toe off, and it provides the extra propulsion to go forward. So the shoe really, for me, worked well when you went a little bit faster. I found it a bit robust for slower, easier runs. The outsole, nothing special to it. Full rubber forefoot, and the two little rubber pieces on the back. A lot of rubber, so it adds to the weight of the shoe. It comes down to about 259 grams, which is, there's lighter daily trainers out there. But you're kind of going to have to weigh up what you want to get out of the daily trainer. So, like I said, I've only done a few kilometers in them. I haven't really tested them out properly on a long run or anything like that. It's really kind of like just a first impression review of the shoe, and I really think it's a shoe that I can spend a lot of time in. Like I said, I find the Pegasus 37 maybe a little bit more forgiving on when the pace is a lot slower. But once you start going a little bit faster, then this really comes into its own. Once you get forward and you get onto the forefoot, the shoe really propels you forward. There's enough here to protect you. There's enough foam here that's gonna give you your comfort and support your foot a little bit. So I think it's a great daily trainer. It's a shoe you can go a little bit faster with, and for what it's designed to do, it complements the Alpha Fly because you don't want to be spending too much training miles in the Alpha Fly. But having said that, I got about 800 k's on my Vaporflies, so the durability on the racing kind of shoes seems to be quite good as well. But yeah, for what the shoe is designed to do, my only negative about the shoe is that the price tag's quite high for a daily trainer. But then again, like I said, it is something that you can use for stem tempo and faster runs. But it definitely ain't a racing shoe. There's a lot better racing shoes out there. If you want to spend that kind of money for a racer trainer, there are better options and cheaper, much cheaper options out there. Yeah, so in a nutshell, that's the Tempo Next Percent. If you enjoy this video and you want to see more, hit the subscribe button, click on the bell to make sure that you get notified when I do more reviews or when I update this after I test these out a little bit more. But yeah, I'll see you guys out on the road. Cheers!